If you're interested in being one of the future snippets, the email is complexambition401@gmail.com. Send us a message and we'll reach back out to you guys.
And also, there's a brand new option for promotion. We have a $50 tier available, limited to 10 people a month on patreon.com/cambition, and we will react to your music. That's right, react to your music on a monthly basis. Cancel the subscription anytime you desire as well. No strings attached.
Woo! Shout out to everyone out there in the world watching this video. You could be watching anything, doing anything right now, but if you're here, I appreciate you. Per usual, another week sound from CA. For those who don't know, welcome to the channel. Subscribe, comment down below, share your reactions throughout the video. Hit the notification bell. More videos coming soon. Go check out the patreon.com/cambition for throwback reactions. We're going to give you a throwback reaction to the future mixtapes. I'm definitely going to do the whole mixtape run that he did a couple years ago. I'm going to do it on Patreon. So go please support it. Only $3. Go please support it. Please join the Discord chat for free. The link's down below. And let's get into it. My favorite rapper maybe of all time. I've been debating this. I love Drake. I love Lil Wayne. But recently, I've been revisiting Future like crazy. His feature run in the past 2 years has been remarkable. It would be on songs that are not even that huge, and his feature, to me, carries the song. We have it with the Nardo Wick record. We have it with the Moneybagg Yo record. These are classic features. Like and it's almost as if like he's on a promo run, but he's not until now, because now we have the official single and video, Worst Day, and he's dropping it a couple days before Valentine's Day. So we already know he's gonna get into his toxic bag. I'm assuming, right? It has to be that. He's executive producing Kanye's album, which comes out in 10 days. I'm not sure how the fuck that's gonna sound or if it's even happening, but we have it coming. And now we have this, Worst Day. We saw the Kevin Samuels skit to promote this song. So let's get into it. Because I'm expecting my girlfriend maybe to break up to me after. Okay, so he starts it with a skit again.
I want to commend you on your bravery. I mean, admitting you have an addiction is never easy. So Chanel.
See, for those who don't know Kevin Samuels, he's toxic king when it comes to online male advice. He's the go-to. He'll rate girls, he'll call girls out, he'll break down the male mind. He actually studied a lot of this stuff as well, so he's not necessarily, you know, DIY like how Fresh and Fit and sort of other creators do it. He definitely has some background in this field. So he's helping Future, it seems, by being his therapist. Future is taking this shit so seriously, it looks like a real fucking video.
Birkin, Dior, APs, five-star hotel. How much did you say you spent on women?
Probably like, let's see, around 2-3 thousand.
$2-3 million, motherfucker!
I'm realizing that I have this problem right now. I need help.
Okay, so it's a Valentine's Day record. Literally a Valentine's Day record.
Valentine's Day, the birthday, got too many to please.
I probably have a pink pen and put my mind at ease. Got a pants out new whips, yeah, but all this one is me. Damn. Got a Glock on the pillow, she blunt for my game. Every single birthday, another private location. Valentine's Day, the worst day, got too many to please.
This shit is hard.
Jeez, all she want is me. She want me to be there on February 14th. I come to when I get a chance, we gotta be brief. See, when you got more than one, two, three, four, five, six bitches, Valentine's the worst day when a nigga rich. I'm more than one.
Listen. Future, you're saying the obvious to me, bud. You're saying the when you got 3 to 4, 5, 6 bitches on Valentine's the worst. Of course, you're putting yourself in a predicament that I don't want to be in. I wouldn't want to ever be in. But there's a lot of men out there that relate to this. And this is for you guys. I don't relate to what my spirit does. Inside, I'm him. I hope my girl doesn't watch this. Like I said, damn, I'm gonna get in trouble. I'm not Future. He's a piece of shit. But I love this. I love it.
They saying they miss me, won't settle for no quickie. Gotta wing up in they Vickies. I leave out and go miss. I done travel to Valentine's Day. The worst day, got too many to please. I pop that pink pen and put my got a Glock on the pillow. She blunt for my game. Not trying to lie to you, I don't want to explain. I'm getting nine, get it in, smashing on acceleration. Do it times 10, upper echelon, heavyweight.
Horrible person. Doing one thing, chasing another, never get you anywhere.
Trench to the floor, keep up, hold pick my mink up. Make reservations, just a chick in my coat. Choose one and you gon' make the other ones feel less than Valentine's Day, the worst day. Got 2 minutes to please. Gotta pass out new whips, yeah, but all this one is me. Got a Glock on the pillow, she blunt for my game. Every single birthday, another private location.
Valentine's Day, the worst day. Got 2 minutes to please. That's a lot of flowers, Future. That's the big stems. Oh shit. She got oh shit. He's gone.
Listen. Let's talk about it. Let's break it down. The song, I love it. I think the video definitely helps me love it more because you got the Kevin Samuels, you have the Valentine's Day actual scenarios, him meeting up with different girls, different outfits, different occasions, and ending it with the girl literally walking out with another guy. You know, like he thinks, like you think you're the player? You think you're pushing P, Future. She's pushing P too. She just walked out with Mr. P herself. So it's like, damn, that's reality for him. But I think definitely Future, I don't think he necessarily, he might live this life, but not necessarily like this. I think he's playing into that whole, how people think like Future's toxic and Future, similar how it was like he's a drug user and like the codeine shit. He used to say like, yo, that's not really me. Like, I don't do that like that no more. Like, I play into it. It's almost like a, not a superhero, but like a character that he sort of like plays on and throws more energy towards, right? He fuels it up and then he gives you guys that action of that. And now we have it, I think, again with this whole toxic recently. I'd rather go with Jada than Will. That whole thing, he's always tweeting something, right? In the hoods, I'm more classic than Jay-Z. Like, he always has this commentary, and he always is viral without trying. And he's huge. His records are huge. Like, I recently was looking at his songs and, like, the numbers on YouTube alone. I'm like, yo, this guy is literally, like, a megastar. But it almost doesn't feel like that. Like, he's so cool. Because, like, he's not really out here. He doesn't do interviews. He's in bullshit, right, on the Shade Room. But he doesn't really, like, he's not, there's no footage of it. Like, it's always, like, random bullshit. Like, I don't know. I like the guy a lot, you know. But it's also, like, this shit ain't healthy. It's fun, but it's not healthy. And I wouldn't recommend it, you know. I know friends, I know people. I do not recommend living a lifestyle like this, you know. I'm Mr. Committed. Or what's it called? I'm Relationship Guy. That's me. Now, if you guys want to hold around, do your thing. You want to live life like Future, do your thing. But Valentine's Day is going to be your worst day. Damn. Speaking of Valentine's Day, I got to go buy something right now. Fuck, this motherfucker just reminded me. I think it's going to grow on a lot of people. I don't think it's an instant hard. Like, for universally. For me, I'm more biased because I'm such a Future stan. But I think it's going to be one of those records that is going to grow on people more. You might play it every Valentine's Day. You're definitely going to play it this Valentine's Day. And it's going to get people talking like, wow, he has a Valentine's Day record. You know, it does miss something for me. There's something missing for me. Maybe a feature. Something's missing for me. Lil Durk would have sounded good on this. Drake, Certified Lover Boy, would have sounded good on this. It's something missing, right? But overall, I'll give it an 8 out of 10. 8 out of 10. It's a strong record, I think. Something's missing, though. There's something missing. Comment down below. What do you guys think is happening? Is there something missing? Is it perfect? Is it 10 out of 10? Am I bugging? Future. We want another fucking album. I can't fucking wait. Let me go buy my Valentine's Day gift.
They gonna love me for my ambition.